Thank you. And you were here this morning.
Amen.
You should love the Lord.
Amen.
You should love the Lord above all else. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you for the call, Brother Jimmy, to do the work for offering this morning.
All the time.
All the time.
All the time.
All the food.
Hallelujah. I hope you're also ready here. Hallelujah. Come on, just smile to me. Come on, guys, let us smile. Yeah, yes, hallelujah. God is good. God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Hallelujah. Our message today will come from the book of John, chapter 14, verse 1. Hallelujah. God is good. What instruction God's saying to us? What instruction is God giving us? only sheep listened to God, if only sheep listened to God, in our inner dreams, sometimes God, in our hearts, we feel God saying to us, and we give excuses, say, what if I do this, what would I do, and I don't have this, and we make all kinds of excuses in our hearts, but we should just listen to what God says. Hallelujah. This morning God is saying, let us give, and shall be given unto you. Let's now share it together and running over. That is the instruction this morning. Hallelujah. Let us follow the instruction that God is giving us and believe in Him for the healing. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Father, Lord, in the mighty name of God, Jesus Christ, all the glory belongs to you, Almighty Father, Almighty Jehovah. All the honor belongs to you, Almighty Jehovah. This morning, Almighty Father, Lord Jehovah, as you say, we must give, Almighty Father. We listen to your instruction, Almighty Father, Lord Jehovah, and believe in you and in your word, Almighty Father, Lord God, and you say in your word. We believe in you this morning, Almighty Jehovah. We pray, Almighty Father, Lord God, Jehovah, that you bless every help that shall be this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We say in your word, Almighty Father, Lord God, Jehovah, that if we give, Almighty Father, Lord God, you will give for us also in the mighty name of God, Jesus Christ. All the glory and all the praise and all the honor belongs to you this morning, Almighty Father, Lord God, Jehovah. We thank you, Almighty Father, you are so beautiful for this day, Almighty Jehovah. We thank you for this time to give you. us free. It's the truth that we know that sets us free. Oh Lord God, for we shall know the truth. And yes, Lord, the truth shall indeed set the people of God free this morning, oh Lord God. We thank you that where the Spirit of the Lord is, oh God, that there is liberty, oh Lord. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, for the power and the authority of the Word of God in our lives, oh Father. In the name of Jesus, Father, we just give you thanks and we give you praise and glory. We give you honor. We give you all the worship, oh God, that in our hearts and our lives this day, Father. We just thank you, Lord, oh God, that you are the master architect, the master builder of our lives, Father. We thank you, Lord, Father, we may not see it, oh God, but Lord, you've already done it, oh God. We thank you, Lord, oh God, that you've given us a glimpse of it, oh God. And by faith, oh Lord, we grab a hold of the Word of God and we move towards it, oh God. We move towards our glorious destiny in Christ Jesus, oh Lord God. We press, oh Lord God, towards the mark of the upward call of God in Christ this morning, Father.
One of us, a dream. a vision, a goal. When God does that, He gives you a word connected to it. Whatever dream you have, it is God given. It's no man,
Jesus,
no man can give you a dream and still give you the ability to bring that dream to pass. It is only God. When God gives you a dream, regardless of what happens along the journey towards the realization and the manifestation of that dream, it will come to pass. If you can write that for me, write it, you know, write it in the front of your Bible if you have to. Write those words, it will come to pass. Those 5 words, it will come to pass. So what are you saying? If you write it in the front of your Bible, it will come to pass. You're saying everything that God has written in this word concerning my life, it will come to pass. The beginning of the year, I shared with you and I don't know if you've done it, I trust you have. But you get a journal or a notebook and you jot down all the things that you're trusting God for. And then you go and look for scriptures that are fulfillment of those things. And as you pray, you remind yourself of those things and you quote those scriptures, because what are you doing? You're speaking word over those things. You're speaking life. You see, some of you, there's stuff that you've trusted God for, things you've been hoping for, and those things are just lying dormant. But you know what will resurrect those things? It's the Word of God and the Spirit of God. Now you write a promise that God has given in His Word concerning that thing. And by you speaking it, remember you are Spirit. The Holy Spirit resides within you. You are one with Him. And when you're speaking, you're releasing Spirit and you're releasing words. Remember the dry bones. The Word and the Spirit had to come. In the beginning, very beginning in Genesis, there was nothing. Everything was, nothing was bad. It was dry. There was nothing. It was just emptiness. It was dark. And many times you find that there are people that their lives seem that way. But you know, I want to share a word of encouragement to you. I don't know what darkness you may find yourself in this morning. But I'm here to tell you that darkness, when you're at the darkest, don't give up, because there's still an opportunity. It's an opportunity for God to step in. It's an opportunity for God to bring life. It's an opportunity for God to bring light so that you can see your way through. It doesn't matter how dark that hour may be, but you can speak words. Speak word, rhema. Declare rhema, spoken word, speak the word. Hallelujah. This word is a grafting word. As you meditate on this word starts changing you. That you understand this word, all of a sudden it becomes your character. It becomes a person in you. You become the word, you become a logos. And then now you start speaking rhema. You start speaking life, spoken word. But you're not speaking what circumstances say to you, but you're speaking what God says. It's time you spoke to the things in your life. You see, what you see is not all that there is. more that God has in store. That's why God has given you a dream. He's given you a vision. He's given you a living hope. And that's why you make and you set goals for yourself. Because you know you have a hopeful future in spite of what's happening around me. My goal, God has given me a goal. I have a God-given goal. I'm moving towards a destiny that God already has planned and created for me. From the foundation of the earth, God predestined it, God preordained it. No devil in hell can stop it. So God gives you a will. Look at this. In Matthew 25, Jesus speaks about the kingdom of God. It's like a man who gave talents. To the one he gave 5 talents. To the other he gave, come on, talk to me, somebody. He gave 2 and then he gave 1 to the other. Listen, it's not the quantity that you've received that matters. It's the quality. You see, many people, they think of this way, I need so much, I need more. I just got, listen, it's the quality. God gives you something. It could be something small. But man, God, listen, if God has given you it, God has qualified you for that. Praise God. Yes. It's not the quantity, it's not the size, but it's the quality. And if you can just work with it. You see, the one with 5, he went, he traded. And he got more. The one with 2, he went, he traded, and he got more. But the one who had 1, the one who had 1, consider his words to the master. He said, my master, my lord, I know what type of man you are. So I was afraid and I went and I buried it. I hid it. You see, so many God has given. There's no such a thing as a talentless individual. The richest, listen, the wealthiest place in the entire world. The wealthiest, let me just bring it home. Let me zoom onto home. You get a picture of this. The wealthiest place in South Africa is not the Beers mine. It's not Anglo-American mine. The wealthiest place, or places, I should say, in South Africa are the cemeteries. Cemeteries are loaded with talents, dreams that never materialized, never came to fruition. And you and I are still alive. God has given us dreams, He's given us vision that need to come to pass. Because those things that God has given you, it's to effect. Listen, you know, many people, when God gives them something, it's always, oh, I can take my breakthrough with this thing. It's never for you. God never does it for you. He does it to affect a nation. He does it to affect the world. Come and talk to me, somebody. I'm speaking to somebody. Come and talk to me. That has an answer that this world is looking for. You have it. It's coupled to that dream. It's coupled to that vision. It's coupled to that goal. But you know what's the problem with many people? It's fear. The biggest obstacle, the root cause of any man's defeat is the mountain of fear. Look at Adam. God came in the cool of the day. Adam, Adam, where are you? Adam says, I'm hiding. God asks, why are you hiding? I was afraid. Because I'm naked. The first time fear was ever mentioned in the Bible was there. You see, the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy, but Christ has come to give us life, life more abundantly. You see, whenever you are, listen, when you connect with God, you connect with your destiny. When you connect with God, that is your connection with your destiny. Because God is the one who holds your future in His hand. And when you take His hand, come on, talk to me, somebody. He holds your future in His hand. And you take hold of His hand. As long as you have His hand, you come on, you are in your future. Oh, you didn't get this. That's why the enemy does that. He wants to keep you out of it. Because he doesn't want you to see the full picture. God says to Adam, who told you? Speaking to somebody here this morning, you're probably saying, I'm too old. Who told you you're old? I'm too weak. Who told you you're weak? Who told you? God is asking you that question. Who told you you're weak? Who told you you're poor? Who told you you're sick? Who told you you're too old? Who told you you can't make it? Who told you you're going to fail? God is saying, who told you? Because I didn't tell you. That's what God was saying to Adam. I didn't tell you that, Adam. So who told you? Where did you get this information from? It's amazing when you read the Bible. Most translations of the Bible mention the words, fear not, 365 times. Most translations of the Bible have the words, fear not, repeated 365 times. Hence, I submit to you this morning, brothers and sisters in Christ, that is not a coincidence. It is not a coincidence. It is there because God is telling you for every day of the year, for the rest of your lives, God is telling you, fear not. Fear not. Fear not. Fear not. Talk to me, somebody. Whenever the angel of the Lord appeared with a message, you found that God always says, fear not. Even when Gabriel appeared to me, he said, fear not. And the angel, come and talk to me. God is telling you, tell your neighbor, fear not. Even Jesus says, fear not, little ones. Fear not. Do not be afraid. Hallelujah. 2 Timothy 1 verse 7 says this, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of love, of power, and sound mind. The Passion says this, for God will never, and when I say never, I'm saying capital letters, for God will never give you the spirit of fear. But He will give you the Holy Spirit who gives you mighty power, love, and self-control. You see, someone who's afraid is afraid of man, what people can do. God will never give you the spirit of fear when you're afraid of men. That's what you find in society today. People are afraid to stand up for what is true and what is right. Because they're rather by faith. Listen, God didn't choose you or appoint you to by faith or to by favor. Listen, when you have favor with God, God will give you favor with men. You don't need to work for it or earn it. It'll just happen automatically. When a man's ways please the Lord. He causes even his enemies to be at peace with him. Because your enemies know, hey, God is with this man. Of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. So fearing God prevents us from fearing others. I remember before I was born again, I was a manager in a private school. And whenever the regional manager or general manager, even the directors would come to the store, I wouldn't sleep. The day before, I'll make sure that store is spick and span. I'll make sure that everything that I know they're going to check is in check. You even find yourself phoning other managers where they've just been to find out what are they checking, so you can make sure that's intact. Nerves would grab a hold of me, fear would grab a hold of me, wouldn't sleep. And then I'm the first one there in the morning, 5 o'clock, I'm there. I used to be so concerned about my day. And then I remember once, one of our regionals, somebody was playing Jim Reeves. You know Jim Reeves, across the bridge. Let's go, no sorrow. You know that one? Someone was playing that CD, and this regional manager, oh, how I love this. Man, I said, that's the secret. Every time he came, I made sure that person brought the Jim Reeves CD. So he had a nice day. But then I gave my heart to the Lord. And when I became born again and I received the Lord Jesus, all fear went. Because the Bible showed me, fear the Lord. Fear God. The Lord is my shield. The Lord is my strength. I shall not fear what man shall do to me. Those words echoed. From then, I was never afraid. When people used to say, you know the boss is coming to you tomorrow. I said, let him come. Because I knew that God would already sort it out. And I've seen how God miraculously thinks God just worked it out. That's why he says, fear not. God gives you the Holy Spirit, gives you mighty power, love, and self-control. The Aramaic for the word self-control. It is translated to the word revelation light. Instruction. Brother Jimmy mentioned that this morning, the word instruction. The Holy Spirit will give you instruction. He'll tell you things to do. You know, I remember Brother Wayne. Many of you know Brother Wayne. Sister Sharma and Brother Eddie's son. He's down in Cape Town. And God, you know, gave him a word. Just hold on. And he was coming. God said, hold on. I'm with you. There was one examination that Brother Wayne wrote. One examination he wrote. And when he went to go write the exam, it's actuarial science. He's a qualified actuary. And those exams are extremely difficult. So he said, Pastor, there's so much to study. I said, just trust God, the Holy Spirit. Just pray and trust the Holy Spirit to give you the paper. So he went and he studied. And then in the evening when he went to sleep, he says, he saw the question paper. He saw the question paper. He got up in the morning, and he did revision, just browsed through what he saw. When he got into the exam room, he says when they were told to turn the page over, and he turned, brothers and sisters. Let's go to Proverbs 29. Proverbs 29. Understand that you have dreams that are coming to pass this year. You understand what I'm saying? Oh, Brother Jimmy, why delay it if you can have it? You see, hope. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So if it's evidence, it means it's a reality, it's yes. But it's a substance of something I'm hoping. Hope! Hope is in the future. But faith is now. Because when you read that scripture, it says, now faith is. Faith is now. Faith is not sometime in the future. The minute it's delayed and it's sent to the future, it's hope. But you see, faith. Faith. You understand it, we've read it in scripture. And there are things that activate faith. I've shared on that. One of the biggest activators to faith is love. If you can walk in love, I'm telling you, things will just work for you. What I'm trying to get across to you is that the Bible speaks about faith moving mountains, mountain moving faith. On your journey to your destiny is where? In the future. That is hope. There's mountains that you face. But faith can take something from the year 2035 that you're expecting it to happen in 2035. Faith can grab a hold of it and faith can move through all the mountains that you who've never walked before. get up and walk. Or even if a person has got a problem in the leg or in the knee, wherever it is, and you tell the person, walk, stand up, the person always is expecting the pain because they fear the pain. That pain that they feel, they're afraid of it, they don't want to feel it again. But when you release a word, when you release a word from God concerning their healing, very often you find a person, oh, it's God. It's God. They say, do what you couldn't do. I couldn't do this. Why? Faith. A wise man once said this. He said, fear not the door. And faith went to open. As soon as faith opened the door, no one was there. You see, when fear tries to knock on your door, you send faith to answer. Getting it? You send faith to answer. Because fear cannot stand faith. Because understand, without faith, it's impossible to please God. You cannot please God without faith. God, we serve a God who responds to faith. How did Bartimaeus get a response from Jesus? By his faith. His faith captures the attention of Jesus. His faith drowned all the voices that were around him, telling him to keep quiet. His faith drowned all of that. You see that woman with the issue of blood? Her faith. You see, she was hoping to be made well. But the Bible says she said within herself, if only I could just touch. So she spoke to herself, if only I could touch. And in that, she saw herself. She hoped that she'd be made well. That was hope. But when she, now, faith went through all the mountains, all the crowds that were thronging around Jesus. Faith went through all those people. Grab the healing. You see, we serve a God who responds to faith. He says, your faith has made you well. Your faith has made you whole. Hence, I'm saying to you this morning, it doesn't matter what you may have lost in your life. It doesn't matter what may be broken in your life. Your faith can bring restoration to your life today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You must understand, as much as faith is a spirit, fear too is a spirit. Fear is a spirit. And it's this wicked spirit of fear that keeps men bound in limitations and stops them from taking bold steps in life. Many times you speak to people, they're afraid of what people would say. What? Excuse me, you're afraid of what people would say? What God has told you what to do? Man whose opinion is greater than the opinion of man or the opinion of God. I don't care what man may say. I don't care what people may think. If I look stupid for the people, I look wise for God. Because the wisdom, the foolishness of this world is wisdom from God. Look at Noah. People looked at Noah. They ridiculed him. They mocked him. You're building a ship in the middle of a desert. Come and get real, Noah. There's no sea close to us. Why are you building this ship? And Noah starts telling them what God said. And they all, it's amazing when you tell people what God said, how they mock you, how they laugh at you, how they spit in your face. It's amazing. But Noah kept his peace. You don't find that Noah cried out to God and said, oh Lord, the people are busy laughing at me. Lord, Lord, I can't handle this. Lord, Lord, I can't do this anymore. No. Noah knew what God had called him to do. yourself busy building. You are busy building. Come on, talk to me. I'm speaking to another in this place. You are building. Never mind the people. Never mind what they say. Never mind what they think. Never mind what they do. You just keep on building. You just keep on building. You know what I'm telling you? When it is finished, watch when the rain comes. The rain speaks of the promise that God has given. Watch when that happens. When that word comes to fulfillment, that word will pick you up higher and higher and higher, and all those who ridicule you will drop. Oh, you're not hearing. You know, we know the scripture that where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. So to overcome fear and to counter the spirit of fear, we need the liberty that the Spirit of God gives. Hallelujah. Proverbs 28:1 tells us the wicked flee when no one pursues, but the righteous are bold as a lion. The Passion Translation puts it this way: guilty criminals experience paranoia even though no one threatens them. But the innocent lovers of God, because of righteousness, will have the boldness, the confidence of a ferocious lion. You with me? In Isaiah 54:14, God says, in righteousness you shall be established. He tells you you'll be established in righteousness. He tells you you'll be far from oppression. Righteousness. And we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, brothers and sisters. Come on, somebody. When you go to Matthew's Gospel, chapter number 4, and from verses 35 to 41, we read about Jesus. Jesus says to his disciples first, he says, you know, they're getting into the boat, and he says, let us go to the other side. You see, God, the day God gave me that dream, the day he gave me that vision, the day he gave me that word, God was telling you, listen, I'm going to relocate you now. Let us go to the other side. Let us go to the other side. And it's amazing that once you respond, that you get into the boat with the master, as soon as you get to the middle of the sea, once you're halfway there, the enemy wants to keep you out. So what happens? There's a storm that moves. So now he troubles your waters to get you troubled, to get you, you know, running in paranoia. Yet the one who told you, let us go to the other side, he said to you, I will never leave you, nor will I forsake you. He says, no, I am with you even to the end of this age. You see, the God who called you, the God who chose you, the God who appointed you, the God who holds you in his bosom, who's carrying you. You may think you're doing it by your own strength, but let me tell you, brothers and sisters, it's the grace of God. That's why you can say like Paul, by the grace of God, I am what I am. The grace of God is working in your life. Don't you see it? The grace of God is working in your life. When others around you are drowning in those waters, you're still standing, you're still standing, you're still standing. When others fall and they become buried, not you, you rise again. Because the Bible says, though a righteous man falls 7 times, you bounce back again. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. that which is of the old. But when he came to Jesus, he put on newness. There's something new. When Jesus said, come, let us go to the other side, when he gave you that word, let us go to the other side, he put you into a new life. Into a new life. Let me ask you a question. If I were to bring you a 1925 Mercedes-Benz that's rusted, man, it looks like Red Villains don't drove that car because it looks like you need to put your foot out to catch, to break. And then I brought a 2022 C63 leather seats right there. And I said, you tell me which car you're going to choose to get to Cape Town. Which would you choose? Which would you choose? The 1925 model? 2022, because 1925, hey, you'll have no heels left. I see, when you came to Christ, he took you out of the old. He put you into the new. You can trust the new vehicle. Hence you're sleeping on the leather cushion. It's a new way of life now. It's a life where God carries you. It's a life where God sees you through. It's a life where you're no longer fending for yourself. It's a life where you're no longer alone. But the disciples were so used of the old. They were used of their old boats. Remember, they were fishermen. And they've seen many a storm at sea. They knew what they were accustomed to. They heard the stories of fishermen who drowned at sea, who lost their lives at sea. And here they were faced with the same. But they found that although they were like that, there's a man that's in the boat that's not even worried, that's fast asleep. They come to him and say, Master, carest thou not that we perish? And says Jesus, got up. And he rebuked the winds and the waves. And there was a great peace. And then he rebuked them. He said, oh, you of little faith. Why did you fear? Why did you fear? Peter was walking on the water. You remember that? The minute he took his eyes off Jesus, he began to sink. Master, save me. I perish. Jesus saves him. Why did you fear? Why? Because on this journey, it's a journey of the miraculous. If you want miracles in your life, you've got to get rid of the fear. As long as you have fear, you can get, which, I don't know, you can get so many pastors in the world to come and anoint you with oil. As long as you have fear, you will not experience any miracle. You'll just be oily. So if you can get rid of all the fear, just have faith. Just have faith. Faith kept a supply of flour and oil for leaders as God's family. And we serve that same God who replenished that jar. We serve that same God. You with me? See, so we can learn from Jesus. We too, brothers and sisters, must be bold so that we too can cross and get to the other side. Every assignment that God has called you to requires you to be bold. You must be bold. Because on your journey, you are going to get them giants. You are going to get them mountains. But there's no mountain that's too high for you. on top of that mountain. Because we just read from the book of Proverbs. When you place your confidence in the Lord, you'll be seated in the highest place. So you're operating in a place that's higher than that mountain. So you need spirit of boldness. So to escape the spirit of fear, we must bind ourselves to the spirit of God. The spirit of God. Hallelujah. Amen. And unless we have the Holy Spirit, we will not make it. A man without the Spirit of God is a man who constantly be plagued with the spirit of fear. Hence we need the Spirit. Even Moses understood this all too well. That when God said, go over to Canaan, he said, go. Unless you go with us, I won't move you. Because the presence of God is all that matters. The presence of God makes the difference. That's the difference. The difference between you and the people in the world is that God is with you. Although Israel was in Egypt, in Goshen, the plagues only hit the rest of the Egyptians, but nothing happened to Israel. While it was dark for the Egyptians, it was day for the Israelites. We serve that very same God. Hence, I submit to you this morning, brothers and sisters, all the scriptures in God's precious word assure us that our case is different to the case of the world. Talk to me. Your case is different. Next time someone tells you that, you say, yeah, speak for yourself. I want a God who's spoken for me already. Lord, come on, somebody. That's like if somebody were to approach Pastor Sharon, approach myself, or approach, come on, Sister Denise or Brother Jeff. They were to approach you and try to, as they call in the world, throw you up. What you gonna say? I'm spoken for. Hello? Am I in the right place? You say what? I'm spoken for. Is it time to throw you out? I'm spoken for. I'm taken. You see, if we can do that in marriage, how about everyday life? When they tell you about, hey, you know things are happening like this in the world, hey, speak for yourself, I'm spoken for. I know whose I am, and I know who I am is. Hallelujah. I'm spoken for. God has already spoken for me. You know what, that thing that you're speaking, it's nice, keep it for yourself, it's not for me. I have a blood covenant, written in the blood concerning me. It's here. That doesn't apply to me. My case is different. Come on, do this with your Bible. Come on, just hold the Bible like this. And do it with some attitude. Say, my case is different. My case is different. My case is different. Glory. Hallelujah. Yes, yes. It is written. It is written. It is written. That's how Jesus overcame the devil. The same devil. Listen, people say another devil. Same devil. Just a different trick, but it's the same devil. Jesus defeated him how? With the word. It is written. It is written. It is written. Eventually Jesus, you know, he said, you know what? Get behind me. You belong behind me. How about you telling fear today? It is written. It is written. It is written. And then you say, get behind me. Because you're not going backward, you're moving forward. Hallelujah. On your journey towards your destiny, you've got the giants, you've got battles that you're going to encounter. And there's all manner of challenges. But it's the Holy Spirit. Spirit will embolden. The Holy Spirit gives you boldness. The Holy Spirit encourages you, gives you strength. When you can't stand, you find all of a sudden you're standing. When you don't know what to say, you find all of a sudden you know what to say. That's what Jesus said. Don't you listen? He said, do not worry what you say, for it will be given to you in that hour. Speaking of the Holy Spirit. On your journey, just like Israel, in Canaan, there's going to be the Canaanites. There's going to be the Philistines. There's going to be the Hittites, the Perizzites, the haters, and the Perizzites. You're going to get it. Don't worry about them. Understand. Don't be a fool. You can't expect a hater to love. It's in his nature to be. Unless he's born again. When he's born again, the love of God is shed abroad in his heart by the Holy Spirit. Now he can start loving. You understand? Come on, somebody. Amen. So you got to just learn to get over it. The Holy Spirit will give you the strength. So always remember, faith is the answer to fear. Told you the story. If you are not, if you are open, nobody. Lastly, remember, fear flees when faith appears. Fear flees. See, like that person, the minute they see, wow, now they have faith, this thing worked, pain is gone. You see, fear took that pain away. That's why it's so important for us to fill our hearts with the Word of God. Because this is a faith factory. If you ever want faith, go to the Word. This is where faith is produced. Spend time with the Word. That's why even when God came to Joshua, he told Joshua, meditate on this Word day and night. Meditate on it. Keep your eyes on it. Keep your mind on it. Keep speaking it day and night. Not only, you know, listen, you don't wait for bad times to start building your faith. You know, when you're confessing your healing, don't wait first for sickness to come in when you start to confess. Confess it long before that. Even when it comes, you say, hey, I told you before, I'm the healed of the Lord. You understand? Day and night, meditate on it. Joshua had to keep his mind focused on the Word of God. That's why God told him to meditate on it. Because God knew that he's going to face the Hittites. He's going to face the Canaanites. He's going to face the Philistines. They're going to face the Moabites. You remember that? They're going to face all of these people. I take note, it's all ites. What do ites do? They bite. They're only on a bite. But remember, they bite you here because they're trying to cripple you to get you. Ow, 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 ow. No, he says you trample on them. Amen. Underfoot. Amen. You see, faith gives you that ability. Faith actually changes your position. Faith places you over so that you can crush and trample underfoot. Amen. Amen. So if you want to possess that which God has apportioned to you this year, you must constantly meditate on the Word of God. Because once your heart is filled with faith, there will be no room for fear at all. Fear will be far from you. Amen. Hallelujah. So you're going to conquer and you're going to overcome every obstacle. I don't care what it is. But as long as you have the Word of God, you will conquer. You will overcome. And you're going to get to the other side. Tell your neighbor, I'm getting on the other side. Come, look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, are you also coming to the other side? Woo! Hallelujah! Oh, glory to God! Hallelujah! Bring to the other side. Come on, this year, make this year the year where you get to the other side. Those dreams that you have, come on. As your pastor, I believe in you, and I believe that you're going to make it. I don't care who said what, you're going to make it. Amen. Praise God. Let us stand. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we just thank you. Bless you, praise you. Thank you for your goodness, O Lord. Thank you for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for your loving kindness, O God. Thank you, O God, for your word, because without your word, O God, where would we get faith from? Thank you, Lord, for your precious word. Thank you for the Holy Spirit who emboldens us. Thank you, Lord God, you give us strength. You give us the victory to overcome. Because, Lord God, this is the victory that overcomes the world, our faith. Our faith is in your word. Our faith is in you. So we thank you, Lord, oh God, that you keep us. Father, we pray this morning that you will grant unto us a renewed appetite, oh God, for the continuous study of your precious word. So that, Lord God, we can contact the much needed faith that we need to always overcome whatever obstacle comes our way. Lord, I pray this morning that you inoculate our hearts, O God, with boldness to go forth from this place, O God, and accomplish all that which you have ordained for us to accomplish in this world. Father, we thank you that as we, Lord God, hold on to your word, hold on to your promises. Lord, O God, we just thank you, O Lord, that we're going to make it to the other side. We don't look at where we are, but we see, Lord God, where you have positioned us. Oh Lord God, seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, far above all principality and power. Thank you, Lord, oh God, that you've given us the victory. Thank you, Lord, oh God, for the blood of Jesus. Thank you for the word of our testimony, oh Lord. For it is by the blood of Jesus, the word of our testimony, that we have overcome the wicked one. I thank you, Lord, that you will bless your people, that you keep them, O Lord, that you preserve them. Thank you for the glorious destiny that you have in store for them. O Lord, O God, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each and every one, both now and forevermore, in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, the Lord preserve you, the Lord make all your plans succeed. May the Lord God grant unto you wisdom, may he grant unto you great peace, may he grant unto you understanding, may he grant unto you the spirit of revelation. the divine enablement to do supernatural things. So you can do it. I'm the anointed one, and he's anointing you. He's your hope of glory. He's the hope of your finance. Come on, he's your hope of glory. He's the hope of your testimony. Doesn't matter what it is. Christ is your hope. The anointing breaks the yoke. It lifts burdens. Can you see those burdens being lifted this morning? Can you see those yokes being destroyed this morning? Oh, Rabu Shando Pramahide, O Shadabro Hoskanabro Hoskanaka. La Roshabro Hoskanabro Hoskanaka. Ero Shabro no Rakiasa de Rahas Hoskanaka. Oh, Rabu Shadabro. Oh, Rakiadi Hoskanaka. Nam Rabu Shadabro Hoskanabro Hoskanaka. You know, when they took the Ark of the Covenant, the Ark of the Covenant, that was the presence of God. He placed it before Dagon in the temple. The Bible says when they got there in the morning, Dagon had fallen to his face. It was like a stump left. It's crushed to powder. So if you can understand what the Word of God means, the Word of God declares to you that great is He that's in you, that He that's in the world. When you understand who resides on the inside of you, you'll stand before any Goliath. You'll stand before any mountain and it will crush to powder. It'll become as powder. Fear will become as powder. The wind of the Spirit will blow it away. All the things you fear are being removed. Just shall live by faith. Oh, Jesus. This is a wonderful life, the life of faith. That's your life. That's your life. Man, that's your life. The same God was with Daniel in that lion's den is with you. If God could change the appetite from of a lion, becoming a herbivore. He's going to do it for you. I don't know about you. I believe in miracles. I believe in the miracle work of God. And I believe God is coming through. Amen.
I perish. Amen. If this could be our moment.